be on the 17th.
I was thinking the word NFL came.
Okay, so here's the next one. This one says 5 World Championships, 6 Western Conference Crowns. And this is his bio in his book, so that's what he's using.
How about this? 3 Bay Packers World Champion.
1965.
They're using World Champion now.
See, I think the word NFL is the word we want. I think it's the word world is the word.
I'm comfortable with it, especially seeing this is in his book called
BART. I would say to you on the very bottom, the dates. I changed the dates to be complete dates. The dash should go where?
Between pick and 1956. Maybe a problem. Part of the next sentence you thought.
Yeah, I was wondering if you were going to
tell me. 300 sees Greens win final play again.
Okay. I believe it.
All right.
They've added it, probably. Hawkins Carlo.
He was back as the NFL quarterback. Threw his first NFL touchdown pass. Got the word during.
Touchdown pass, and then take out the word during.
During drops down.
Oh, yes.
Goes on the next line.
I got it.
And touchdown pass can go there, but I don't think it's necessarily the second time. Green Bay Packers rookie NFL quarterback threw his first NFL touchdown during the score exhibition game.
Perfect.
Lottery's team.
Yep.
That's excellent. I like that too. Why? That's almost like it's a disjointed sentence.
Yeah, right.
Yep.
What if you turn those two around? Those two, one and two, and those two.
Okay.
I'd rather see it like this.
Yeah.
But.
You had to abbreviate, yep.
And I don't know.
Yeah, that
is true.
Howard, way to go.
That's why you get the big bucks in Howard. Okay. But I don't know if this photo is the best photo to have on the front cover. But I noticed on your email that you would say, can we have pictures of the plaque? This would be like the inside of the plaque. It has a picture of the plaque, a picture of the plaque, a picture of this and that. Then that's what that flap should be for.
It's to, yep.
And my suggestion would be to heat that up and then get it back to me as soon as possible. And I'll just write all over it so I can copy it onto this.
First glance, Carla, that's incredible. I just love that.
Thank you.
That's doing it up. We've got what's there to question in terms of the process? You have the plaques, you've got the documentation with the original program, you're telling the story. Wow.
So kind of uses your
plaque.
Because she can actually start soliciting her plaque with what I've been able to
do. Okay.
She wants us to firm this up.
1956, team pitcher, roster, number 15, BART STARR. Number 15, BART STARR.
So.
This is 1956.
Right.
So he is wearing 15 in 1956.
So I think what
he
it
must
was.
Must have changed it before, because the guy that had it 15 in this book ain't even on a roster, so he must have had cut.
I have it in a book somewhere that he was actually drafted, and at the time of the draft, he was given number 42. And then obviously by the first preseason game, when he came here, he was wearing 16. My guess is that by regular season, then he was wearing number 15.
This would be regular, the team that made the cuts.
Okay.
So evidently, the guy who had 15, when we had his name,
yes,
he got cut. He changed jerseys before the regular season.
But you want this to be different than what I have? It's...
Hit us one more time.
So far it's the reproduction of the 1956 Green Bay Packer program sign, the BART STARR, and an intimate dinner in a private room at the Armory with BART and Sherry.
Do you really think that we should go with him autographing these things?
Only one.
I mean, what?
Only one.
Only one what?
There would only be like four or five.
I come across a picture of a good-looking rock star, and I just don't know who that might be.
Wow.
It was all buff. Joe, that's 1994.
Phone's not paying me. How did I come in here without my phone?
Nothing.
Okay, I gotta go.
Yeah, I was.